Well, let me begin by saying or advocating that I'm sure and positive that we can annihilate the military and governmental infrastructure of Hamas. Yes, we cannot take out from the minds of the Palestinians the very notion of the Islamic Brotherhood and radical Islam or other stuff. But on the other side, we can root out the military infrastructure and the governmental infrastructure. And I'm saying once again, I mean, we have systematic ways to manufacture new targets. Actually, we are very good at manufacturing new targets. This is an ongoing process while fighting. We have the troops, we have the capabilities, and we have to counter, spread out our forces. We have to cover the territory with our forces in order to find, I won't say each and everyone, but most of those terrorists and this infrastructure. You know, the best example I can give you is Defensive Shield. I mean, so many people were skeptical about our capability to root out the Palestinian terrorism from Judea and Samaria. Truth must be said, the case in the Gaza Strip is tougher. It is much harder, but we are using one-ton bombs and we are dropping 400 of them every night. So we are not using the same methods. But once again, I'm going back to all those who are rightfully asking tough questions and challenging us. My friends, it will take time. Defensive Shield, I mean, the first stage was 6 weeks, and then it took us almost 3 years to almost fully eradicate the Palestinian terrorism. So it's I'm not saying that we need 3 years, but we can't complete the mission by after 3 months. We cannot. And that's why I keep going to the same or this is the cornerstone of running this campaign. Time. And yes, we need to do our utmost to gain and to preserve time and to try to mitigate the conditions for the United States to create for us time and other conditions. Yet the international community, leading by the United States, must understand that they must give us time and that they cannot tolerate, that they won't tolerate Europe and the United States and other modern democratic liberal states, they cannot tolerate any other outcome but full destruction of the Hamas. I want to say something about the chronic disease. You know, every metaphor has its limits. So, in that regard, people can decide that they don't want to live with this chronic disease, and they will leave the country. And they will leave the country. Or they won't go to the northern Galilee or to the southern part of the state of Israel. They will say, no, we do not want anymore to live with chronic disease. No. I'm not willing to stay in this territory, in this, so to speak, holy land, and its chronic disease. And that's why we are, and I'm hoping that we are on the verge of a paradigm shift, and we are in inflection point.